Welcome, dear student, in my channel, in which we are going to discuss the zoology. Today's lecture, we are going to deal with the animal diversity first for first year BSc zoology student. Now, before going to start the topic, you are requested, please do subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for the new videos update. From my earlier video, we have discussed the syllabus as well as the taxonomy and systematics along with the Linnaean hierarchy. Now, after this, in today's lecture, we will discuss the concept of species and nomenclature. So, let's start the today's topic. Concept of species, which include biological and evolutionary, and along with this we will see introduction to binomial nomenclature. So what is the concept of species? According to Linnaeus, species is unchangeable unit. He followed artificial system of classification and he considered only the morphological characters for defining the species. We have already discussed about this artificial system of classification along with the natural and phylogenetic system of classification. What is the artificial system of classification? Which only includes the morphological characters to be considered while classifying the organisms. This has been used by Linnaeus. Later on, Lamarck and Darwin put forward their evolutionary thought. Hence, the monotypic concept was replaced by polytypic or dynamic concept. The later concept states that the species undergo modification in course of time in order to adapt themselves to the ecological niche and may gradually form another species under favorable condition. But in recent years, the approach of biology has radically changed. Today, characters, physiological, genetic, ecological and phylogenetic points are taken into consideration for the systematic arrangements of living organisms. These new insights have moduled the idea of species. Later on, Dobozowski, 1937, has defined the species as a group of individuals which, while passing through the orderly of evolution, has been physiologically and genetically incompatible of inbreeding with other of individuals. So that is the definition given by the Dobozowski. Then again, there are some scientists who also give their views on the species. Emerson proposed that the species is that which has evolved by reproductive isolation and genetically distinct group of natural population. Mayer called species as a group of actually or potentially interbreeding natural populations, which are morphologically distinct and reproductively isolated from the neighboring natural groups. Mayer definition of species is based upon the biological parameters such as reproductive isolation and common gene pool. Hence, it is called biological species concept. In 1961, Simpson viewed species as a lineage, means an ancestral descendant sequence of populations, evolving separately from other and with its own evolutionary role and tendencies. This is evolutionary concept of species, in which the time factor has been added to and the concept has laid much emphasis on phyletic lineage. Christopherson proposed that a species is a single lineage of ancestral descendant sexual populations genetically integrated by historically contingent events of interbreeding. This is ontological species concept. With the new concept of species in mind, modern taxonomists want to establish natural system of classification. So this is about the different scientists who gave their views or suggestion on the formation of species. Now, according to this, or by the different kinds of the parameters and the views of scientists, they generally give the different kinds of the types of species. There are different types of species. First is allopatric species. So what is allopatric species? The two or more related species that have distinct geographical range are called allopatric species. Examples of such species are Indian lion, Panthera leo persica, and African lion, Panthera leo lea. So these are the lions, but they are geographically inhabitant of different areas, like Indian lion inhabit in India, especially in Gir forest in Gujarat, while African lion is far away from Indian lion. So this is geographically isolated species. Then second one is sympatric species. Two or more species are said to be sympatric when their geographical distribution overlaps, though they may segregate into different ecological niche. Examples of this type are the fig frog. This is fig frog actually, Rana garrulea, and the gopher frog, Rana areolata. The former is extremely wide, latter species is restricted to the margins of swamps area. So this is sympatric species. Then third one is parapatric species. These are the species which have the geographical ranges with very narrow region of overlap. Examples, the flightless Australian grasshopper, Moraesa scrua, and Moraesa vatica. These species form in nature mostly through chromosomal rearrangements. So this is parapatric species, narrow region of overlap, and sympatric, their geographical distribution overlap. Then the fourth type of species is sibling species. Two or more than two closely related species which are morphologically alike but behaviorally or reproductively isolated from each other. Examples are Drosophila persimilis and Drosophila pseudo obscura. So these are the two examples of sibling species. Then in mosquito Anopheles maculipensis complex consists of several subspecies, of which few are vector of malaria and the rest are harmless, which do not cause the disease. So this is sibling. Then the fifth one is cryptic species. These species are alike on the basis of observed features but are genetically and sexually different. Cryptic species are incapable of interbreeding, but sibling species are capable of interbreeding but do not produce fertile hybrid. Then the next one is monotypic species. When genus include a single species but does not include any subspecies, which is called as monotypic species. Then next one is polytypic species. When species contain two or more subspecies, which is called polytypic species. For example, Indian tiger, Panthera tigris tigris, Chinese tiger, Panthera tigris amelensis, Siberian tiger, Panthera tigris alpaca, then Javan tiger, Panthera tigris sondica, etc. Javan means which found in Indonesia, Java and Sumatra islands. So these are the different types of tigers which found in different countries. So these are, though they are belong from the same genus and same species, but due to this geographical variations or geographical region, they have certain dissimilarities, and with this they have given the subspecies name, which is polytypic species. Then endemic species, the species which are found in a particular region called endemic species. For example, Darwinian finches found only on Galapagos Island, Indian rhinos, Indian elephant, Nilgiris, which are only found in India. So this is endemic, found at the particular region. The next one is transient species. Species among contemporaneous organisms, fossils, or recent, called transient species. The next one is agamospecies. Species are those which consist of uniparental organisms. They may produce gametes, but fertilization does not take place. They reproduce by obligatory parthenogenesis. In case of bees, wasp, haploid eggs develop into haploid individuals. Eggs are fertilized by sperms. So this is agamospecies. Obligatory parthenogenesis, obligatory, compulsory. And parthenogenesis means this uniparental situation in which the female without mating with the male can able to produce the new offspring. So this is called as the parthenogenesis. Then next one is panmetric species, which is a single interbreeding population occurs, means species in which single interbreeding population occurs are called as panmetric species. And the next one is apometric species, species in which there is a mixing of gametes between different individuals, which is called as apometric species. So these are the different types of species. Now afterwards we'll see the nomenclature. So this is concept of species, how the species are going to be formed, how they are to be defined by the different scientists at the particular time. Then later on we'll see the nomenclature. The common name of a species often varies with the language. Onion in English, Pears in Hindi and Bengali, Vengayam in Tamil, Iruli in Kannada and Kanda in Marathi, and so on. So there are different languages which use the different word for that particular object. Then common names do not serve the purpose because a particular animal is known by different names in different parts of the world. That's why there is a need to give a specific name to that particular organism. For example, the bird house sparrow is known as Goria in India and Pakistan, but it is known by different names in other countries. It is called pardal in Spain, house sparrow in England, Suzoon in Japan and Moosh in Holland, and so on. Many times the common name is also used for different kinds of animals. For example, the name of Quechua is used both for the earthworm as well as Ascaris. Thus, in classification, naming is very important, which is called nomenclature, to avoid the ambiguity. Nomenclature is the system of naming of plants or animals or group of plants and animals. Taxonomists use the specific names for organisms. When taxonomist identifies and describes the natural group of animals or plants, he gives appropriate scientific names to these groups. The scientific name in internationally accepted or universally used for a particular species or a particular group of animal. So that particular specific name or scientific name which is worldwide accepted. And after this nomenclature, how the nomenclature is to be given, we will see the introduction to binomial nomenclature. Bi means two naming system. In naming an organism, the name of the species is composed of two words in Latin. Hence, the nomenclature is called binomial nomenclature. The first word is called generic name and it identifies the genus to which the species belongs. The second word, called specific name, which identifies the species itself. It is also known as two naming system. The genus in plural it is called a genera, is a group of related species which have several characteristics in common. The name of the taxonomist who first described the species name is a scientific journal is added at the end. As an example, Homo sapiens Linnaeus, or L for short, is a complete scientific or technical name for the modern human species. Here, Homo is the genus to which the species belongs, and sapiens the specific name which identifies the species. In this case, Linnaeus was the first author to have published species name Homo sapiens. It also important to note that the generic name always begins with a capital letter, whereas the specific name does not. The scientific name should be printed in italic and underline when typed or handwritten. Thus, it is Homo sapiens, which is written in italic, and not Homo sapiens, which is all letters are small, and not Homo sapiens, in which genus and species letter are capital, or not Homo sapiens, that is all letters are capital. So remember this thing. This is the rule while give labeling the name to the animals. Actually, binomial system is a very old in one idea. Greek nouns were used for genera into Latin. This results into two words in the generic name. These were called binary generic names. The another idea was to use descriptive phrases for specific names. When the binomial system nomenclature was first used by Linnaeus, the appropriate Latin or Greek common names were used. For example, Homo, which is man in Latin, becomes Homo, and ficus, that is figure in Latin, become a ficus. Technical names continued to be given in Latin when words in a language other than Greek or Latin are used. They are Latinized with suitable endings. For example, banyan is ficus bengalensis. Here, bengalensis means from Bengal, where the banyan is commonly found. In some organisms, like fossil and most organisms, are known by their technical names only in some cases. The generic and common names are same. Thus, gorilla is gorilla and eucalyptus is eucalyptus. To avoid confusion, no two generic names in any kingdom can be the same. Specific names can, however, be repeated, as they often quality the generic names. For example, the specific name of both mango, that is Magnifera indica, and tamarind, Tamarindus indicus, are the same and mean of India. Being in Latin, the gender of the specific name follows the gender of generic name, and hence the difference in word ending. Often, specific name of animal and plants are given in honor of some person. If the person honored is a man, the specific name ends in I. For example, the earthworm Lumbricus friendi is a name after Rev. H. Friend. If the person honored is a woman, the specific name end AE. Sometimes the specific name indicate a locality, example Indica for India, or color, example Niger for black. It is customary to write the name of taxonomist after specific name. If the species after its publication transferred to any other genus or the generic name is changed, the first author name is written in brackets or parentheses. For example, Panthera leo Linnaeus means the species leo was originally assigned by Linnaeus to some other genus Felis. So this is about the binomial nomenclature. Then we'll see the trinomial nomenclature. Tri means three naming system, which include genus, species along with the subspecies. When nomenclature consists of three names called trinomial nomenclature. The three names are genus, species and subspecies, as I have told. Thus, use of subspecies is the third name in this method of naming. The subspecies name is also Latin or Latinized word and follows the name of species to which it belongs. For example, the house crow Carvus splendens is found in India, Pakistan, Burma and Ceylon. There is slight morphological difference in house crow of India and Pakistan as well as Burma and Ceylon. Therefore, they are separated as distinct subspecies. Like the Indian and Pakistani house crow has subspecific name Carvus splendens splendens. The Burmese house crow Carvus splendens insolens and Ceylonese house crow Carvus splendens rutigatus. This type of naming is trinomial nomenclature. Botanists do not recognize a subspecies category. There is an International Commission on Zoological Nomenclature, that is ICZN, and commission set up by International Congress of Zoology in 1898. This body has a frame the rules which would be binding for all scientific journals dealing with the taxonomical work. The aim of this organization is to make the stability in naming the taxa, avoiding the use of names which may cause error, ambiguity or confusion. The International Zoological Congress is responsible for standardization and legislation of nomenclature. Now, here are following common rules and recommendations considered as essential for nomenclature, which include: the naming system adopted is binomial nomenclature to indicate the specific name and trinomial nomenclature for subspecific name. The generic name is a single and always begins with capital letter. The specific name begins with small letter. The name of taxonomist who first described the species name in a scientific journal is added at the end. It should be abbreviated and is printed in Roman type. The scientific or technical names of plants and animals must be different. Then, the scientific names should be printed in italics and they must be in Latin or Latinized form. Care should be taken that within plant and animal kingdoms, no two genera can have the same name, as well as within a genus, no two species can have the same name. If the species after its publication is transferred to any other genus or the generic names change, the first author name is written in bracket. A name may be based on any part of an animal's life cycle. Now, there are again some recommendations, suggestions should be considered while giving the new names. A name should be in Latin or it should be Latinized with suitable ending. In the new name, there should not be less than 3 or more than 12 letters. It should be easy to pronounce. The name should describe some important characteristic of the organism. A name should be derived from a single language. A name should be important. So these are some recommendations while giving a new name to the any new species or to change the classification order of the earlier species. So with this, I conclude the concept of species as well as binomial and trinomial nomenclatures. Hope you understand all these concepts in this lecture. And still, if you have any doubt, please feel free to write into comment box. So I will try to solve your query. Thank you very much.